Hello everyone, welcome back to the Power BI 0 to Hero playlist. My name is Sandeep Rathuri. In today's video, I will explain you how to import multiple files into Power BI using the folder option. This is a very useful feature when you have a similar files like sales data for different months in separate files. Now, let's discuss the prerequisite for using the folder option. First is folder structure. All files you want to import should be located in the same folder. This can include files of the same format such as CSV, text or Excel files. Second is consistent file format. The files should have a consistent structure, same columns and data types to allow Power BI to combine them effectively. If the structure varies, it may lead to error or incomplete data. Third is data types. Ensure that the data types of the columns are consistent across all files. For example, for all files, date column format should be the same. Now, I will show you the file folder. Here you can see that I have one sales folder where I have all 3 months of sales data. And if you look here, the number of the columns, column sequence and data format are the same for the all files. Now, I will show you the practical demonstration how you can load multiple files into Power BI to using folder option. Under Home tab, click on Get Data option. Select more. Here you can search for folder. Select the folder, click on connect. Here you can enter the folder path, else you can browse the folder. My folder name is sales. Click on OK. Again, click on OK. Here is my file name. This is file extension. And here you can see the file path. In bottom, you can see the combine option. Once you open it, it will show you the two options, combine and transform data. Second is combine and load. What is the difference between both? If you choose first option, combine and transform data, Power BI will combine all three files into one file and navigate to you Power Query Editor window. There you can perform the transformation and after that you can load the data into Power BI desktop. If you will choose second option, combine and load, so Power BI will combine all three files into one file and directly load into the Power BI desktop. So we will go with second option, combine and load. So here you can see the preview of data. So this is the first file preview. So let's suppose I want to see the January file data. So just select the January file. So here you can see the preview of January file. Click on OK. So here you can see here Power BI combined all three files into one file and file name is sales. And if you want to see the preview of file, go to the table view and here you can see the all data. And if you notice here, Power BI created one extra columns with source name so that you can easily find the file wise data. Now I will show you the transformation option which Power BI performed to combine all three files. So for that, select the data set, click on edit queries. It will navigate to your Power Query Editor window. And in left hand side, you can see the transform file from sales and helping queries. You can see here. So to combine the all three files into one, so Power BI perform these queries in backend. So don't delete this query. Now you can close the window. And what will happen if any new file comes under that folder? So now I will place one more file in that folder. You can see here I have apparel sales file. Now I am moving this file into under sales folder. Now I have one more new file, which is apparel sales file. Now go to the Power BI desktop and here you can see still I have only three files data, January, February and March. Now you don't need to do anything, just click on refresh button. You can check the data. So here you can see the apparel files data. Because to combine the files, Power BI already has created helping queries and transformation step in Power Query. So you don't need to perform this step again and again. Whenever any new file comes under that folder with same format, same sequence and same data type, you have to just click on the refresh button. So Power BI automatically combine the data into same table. That's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more great content. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.